I do. So looking at knife painting on the Isle of Skye bridge with liquin oleo pasto and artisan oil colours. And this would be part four, which would mean working further wet on dry and trying to build up smaller areas of texture that add detail and edge quality in a landscape. So I have worked on this area a bit more, and I'm going to have a look at this middle distant area with yellow ochre, white, crimson, making this colour of copper colour or bracken in the landscape. Two very different sources of colour here, and liquin. So I'm going to try that colour and cut through just here. It's a little bit light and a little bit warm. So this boggy plain beyond the bridge. A little more liquin. What I'm trying to focus on are the areas that haven't got any paint yet, and the particular profile of this middle ground, this middle distance. So that edge. It sort of fades into darkness over there, so I can't do any more with that. But here, got a little bit more there. That is lighter and this is darker. So it's important these little distinctions in tone become very significant. And now that I've got some kind of colour almost everywhere, this area should be darker. It's more ultramarine and cad yellow. A bit of liquin, tiny bit of red and green to darken it. See if I can make a darker green. So this edge along here is a little different to how I painted it the first time. The ground is rising, the green is quite dark there. Because the first layers were quite thin, this is a little easier to work on. I scrape over, I want some of that coppery colour coming through. It's very patchy, patchy sort of landscape. There's a rather dramatic series of bumps in the landscape here. So I'll try to put in. Again, using this small palette knife. And these bushes beside the river, another layer of colour. There is more vertical distance in this version, the painted version. This is where this sort of melts away on the right, but you can still see a difference. Just there's the colour difference, but not much of a tonal difference. So there's very little to distinguish tonally between that value and this value. But what happens when you drag a knife over is some of the colours persist from underneath. So I can see colour coming through from behind. And the nearer bank, there's not a lot of difference, but there is some difference. So this nearer bank is a little more copper colour, or ochre coloured. There, slightly lighter. As long as it's light against dark, dark against light, that's enough of a difference to be able to read it. Let's try and wipe this off a little bit. So the tones, yeah, we've got light, this should be greener and lighter. Let's dip it up that hill. See if we can get the right sort of tone. Just a little bit lighter there. They're not quite so ochre. I can push the knife the other way. So it is becoming much more three-dimensional, this painting. It's becoming far thicker in paint. So that's a slightly greener ochre against a warmer copper ochre, and that's a little bit of refinement at this stage. So there's a little touch of that grey-green ochre on this sunlit side of this mountain far away. Somewhere through there. So there's now a bigger difference between that and the foreground, which has got more copper in it. Ochre and crimson. A little bit of both. Crimson easily overwhelms ochre. And then go back and... So, is there some red ochre? Perhaps lower down. Red ochre, I'll put that as a hotter colour lower down. So that works quite well because it's on a dry surface. Get this organic look to the mark. And same here, this is on a dry surface. Difficult to explain this area here, but there is a road running through it, and that might be helpful. I can put the road in here, pale grey. So the road goes up here, it goes at an angle that way. Then goes off to the right, something like that. So I'm using my hand to go up here, and it just gives a contour in the landscape. Looks like there's another road through there somewhere. So the bridge is important. We need to get to the bridge. Make that a little more ochre coloured in this middle distance. It's rather hard to define what's happening here, except it's boggy ground. A little bit less pressure on the knife. Quite dark, it's come down here. So that's mostly, it's got some description on much of this, and much of this. But there's a little bit less description lower down. Bushes and trees, gorse bushes probably, through here. A bit narrowing, so I'm looking at how much of the river can you see? Not as much. Scrape that over the top. A little bit of darker green, darker colour. It's there. Darker colour at the foot of the bridge. A bit of darker colour along the edge of the riverbank. There are stones all along here. They've got a little bit of dark in them. Okay, the odd bit of boulder or stone. This is a dark mix of ultramarine ochre and crimson. So at the foot of that bridge is darker in the stones alongside the road. Something similar happening over here. This is quite dark. On the edge of the bridge with the grasses. And there is a road there too, but that is grey. So it's much easier to change the colour on the knife. There's a blue-grey in that road coming through there. And I'll trace it the same colour there. So the river is a sort of slate ochre grey colour. Think phthalo blue and white and a little bit of ultramarine to make a colour that might work for the river. And bits of blue as well. Because there is some blue higher up. There's a lot of white water in the river. So I'll try to paint that as well. A bit more of the medium. There's a darker end. There's the pointed edge of that pier. Something like that. A bit of perspective there. And there's darkness there too. So there are stones in this river, and there's green as well, with yellow, I think cadmium yellow, and blue-green, and white. Yep, there's a trace of green in the water. Shallow river, fast flowing. A little bit of crimson with that colour. Makes it more grey. Once a lot of that mid-tone is on there, I'd be interested in putting in some of the lighter and darker values. And the darker values would be the shadow cast by the tower. These pillars, rather, cast a shadow into the water. Reflection, I think. And shadow. There is reflected light in that though, so it's just not just darker. So light then, whitish grey, whitish blue, and mix some of that. So just here there's a sort of natural weir in the river. Altering the angle of the knife. So there's a lot of white water in this fast flowing stream. I'm making this area less white with phthalo blue and yellow ochre and a little bit of crimson. And I'm going to use a cleaner white. Try and find a cleaner white. Something like that. Look for these white water in the foreground here. When you put the paint on with a knife, it gives a sort of torn look when it's dragged, when the paint is dragged at the last minute by the knife. So there's a rock just here, which the water is flowing around. And that's that sort of torn look on dry. I think can help that sense of the fast flowing water. Even in the shadow, there is highlight. White water, rather. It's quite reflective, but... So this area here, this is muddy bank. Most of the canvas has got something on it, most of the board has got some sort of value on it. It's still not very complete in terms of description. Depends how far. It's a bit lighter there. The parapet of the bridge. Better, it's this longer knife, be better at doing that and get the light colour right. I'm going to pick up colour on the length of the long knife, something like that, and just print off, see if I can print off that edge. Doing the parapet, or the light on the top edge of the bridge. And I'm seeing the other side, it was really quite a narrow bridge. I've got that again on that edge. Yeah, it's still a bit too wide there. Pressing that light on that edge. So most of the painting has some kind of value, second layer of value on it. And that's the intention, I think, with this layering process, to build up across the painting rather than one place, to build up colour. So nearly everywhere now has got some second layer, maybe even third layer. And the colours that aren't in this so far are the brighter, sort of yellow greens that grass seems to grow in winter, into this quite a bright, quite a strong yellow green that's in places. But if I scumble that on top of dry, something like this, you get a suggestion of texture. It's a bit too much there. Just let some of the colour come through from underneath. Wipe that off. So that's a little too much there. Push that back. And the same thing is happening over here. Foreground greens. That's phthalo blue and cadmium yellow make a very strong green. Should be some of that elsewhere. Some trees there. And a little bit there and on the other side of the road. In the near foreground. So there is more paint, another layer of paint. I'm trying to make it descriptive. Over much of this. And one final pass, just to look at what's left on the palette. Because with the liquid medium, the oleo pasto, it's going to dry very fast. And there won't be time. Can't see this. Anyway, it's going to dry fast, and so putting in this darker edge here, for example, if I've got some colour that will do that, I'm going to try it. Let's put some light on top of that. This sort of stone grey mix all the colours together.